pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Erie High. I'm Shelby Hayes, and welcome to Royal TV. Today is Friday, March 3rd. Congratulations to the boys' basketball team on their victory over Pittsburgh City League champion. They will not compete for the District 6 champion title. The game will be played on Friday night. Go Royals! Baseball tryouts will be held next week. Tryouts will be on Monday, March 6th from 6:30 till 8:30 p.m. and Wednesday, March 8th from 7 till 8:30 p.m. They will be held at Brandel Painting's Baseball Facility at 23-25 Broad Street. Erie High staff members, you can come out and support your Erie High cheer and tennis teams. A bingo fundraiser will be held on Friday at the JPTF Bingo Hall. Tickets are $30 in advance and $35 at the door. You must be 21 years or older to attend. This event is BYOB. Mr. Orlando joins us with a recap of changes to the PBIS award system.
All right, so the reading here, a reading was a lot of the questions here. If you just look through some of this, it would have helped you answer 1 through 7 there. What I noticed when I was grading was that some people answered part of the question, but then neglected the other part of the question. So one thing we get to practice today is answering all parts of a question. You're gonna get hit with that type of stuff on the Keystone, so I just wanna make sure that we're aware of that. So the first three questions were two-part questions. You'll see what I mean here. So for number one, so it's two-parted. We were looking for another name for a membrane and then trying to identify the overall structure. So there's one part, two part. What is
So, today we're going to learn about graphical user interfaces, or GUIs. Please take this time to put your phone away. The phone case is in the back, so please, if you're going to be distracted by your phone, put your phone in the case and I'll give you some PBIS points.
VR3 Classroom Expectations for Responsibility. Arrive to class on time with classroom materials, prepared to learn. Bring required materials to class, such as pencils, notebooks, and binders. Keep phones off and away in a pocket or purse during instruction. Use classroom electronics for academic assignments only and stay on task. Be honest, trustworthy, and a positive role model to your peers.
Good morning, teachers. Good morning, students. Wanted to come on announcements today just to go over our new things we're doing with our phones, electronic devices, our phones down, grades up initiative that we started. I know a lot of students especially are asking why would we want to do that? Well, last school year, we had only 62% of our core classes, social studies, science, language arts, and math, being passed throughout the school year. And what we found are a lot of our students are not engaged in class because they're on their phone. We actually show in our statistics that we have a 400% increase in student phone uses over the last year in school. So that is why we turned the Wi-Fi off, and that's why we're coming to our phones down, grades up initiative that we have. This year we had a school goal of at least raising our passing rates in those core classes to 68%. in the first quarter. In second quarter, we went over a little bit of that 68%. So we did hit the goal, but we're not doing well enough. With that 400% increase, like I said, in student phone usage in the building, and that being identified as the number one reason why students aren't engaged in class and passing the lessons, we felt it was very necessary to make this move for the success of our students. So students, just so you know, the BR3 team did come up with some new systems to reward you for not being on your phone in class. So it used to be that you could earn 3 points when you went into class and you're responsible, respectful, and resilient. Now you can earn 5 or 6 points, and I'm gonna tell you how. So you can earn 5 points in a class, 1 point for respectful, 1 point for responsible, being in class, doing all your work, being there on time, using the smart pass correctly. But now you can earn 3 resilient points in a class for meeting the teacher's expectation for the lack of phone use during their lesson and their teaching. So that's the way you can earn 5 points. You get 3 resilient points for just staying away from that phone for that lesson. You can get 6 points during a block if during third block you have second or third lunch and you have to return after lunch back to your class. And how that will work is, okay, you have to be respectful, responsible, and resilient to get the 5 like all the other blocks, but you get an extra point for responsible if you return to your class from lunch on time. So that gets you up to 6 points in the block if you have second or third lunch during third block. So with the increase in points, that means that you get increase in PBIS rewards, the t-shirts that you see your teachers wearing all the time because they're giving you the points throughout the week. So also with this, we're gonna have your name and drawings. We're gonna look at the resilient points. And those students that have a lot of resilient points because we know you're off of your phones, we're gonna put you in drawings for bigger prizes like TVs, AirPods, game units. Now, how do you get those phone points, those resilient points? There's a lot of ways. Well, so the kids that don't bring phones to school, you're always gonna get those 3 points in class because you'll never have your phone out and be disrupting class or hurting your education with it. You also, everyone has the opportunity to have a locker and a lock given to them from their homeroom teacher on their A days, their first block teacher. You can have your phone in your locker. It doesn't go in class, you get 3 points. While you're in class, if you have your phone just in your pocket or meeting the expectation of the teacher, not disrupting the lesson, you can get your 3 points. And also now every teacher will have a little calculator holder in their room with the numbers assigned to students that if you need to so bad to keep that phone off you, to put in that calculator holder, and you do that for the lesson, you can get 3 points that way as well. So we have a lot of options for you. We're not taking your phones away. We're not making you put them in the calculator holder. But whatever we have to do to get you to get that phone down, grades up, so you get your credits and graduate on time is what we're gonna do. We also have a lot of students saying, well, what if for safety? What if I need my phone for safety? Well, the one thing I can guarantee to you students is there's not one safety plan that is written by the school district that has you using your own personal cell phone. Okay, we do not rely on student cell phone usage in safety situations. So that is not anything that you need to bring up. All of the resources that the school district needs you to use, like your Chromebook, that are issued to you from the school district, will automatically connect to the Wi-Fi. So your education won't be an issue, right? And teachers also know that they have NetRef to watch what you're doing on those devices and block anything you're going on those devices as well. So that is the why, that is the how behind what we're doing with the phones down, grades up. Remember, we want all of you to be successful, and that's why we're doing it.
Spirit Week kicks off next week. Monday is Favorite Team Day, Tuesday Celebrity Day, Wednesday Culture Day, Thursday Purple and Gold Day, and Friday is Color Wars. Next Friday at 2:30, we will be having a Mr. and Mrs. Erie High pageant in the gym. All juniors and seniors will attend the event. Get ready to hit center stage and show off your talent. Erie High is hosting a talent show on May 4th. Students will perform during the school day with PBIS points and that evening at 6 p.m. for $1 per person. If you are interested, sign up in Miss Nikolai's room, B160, by March 15th. Auditions will be held on March 22nd in the auditorium after school at 4 p.m. The medical assistant class is doing a fundraiser selling Staginellis. The sale is going on now until March 24th. All sales will be delivered on April 11th. If you want to place an order, see Ms. Lofton in room 202/248. Money raised will be used for students' medical kits. Don't forget to support the junior class and enjoy great popcorn. The junior class will be doing a potluck popcorn fundraiser. There are a variety of flavors to choose from, including say cheese, birthday cake flavor, cinnamon pretzel, garlic parmesan, and dill pickle. Each bag contains 5 cups of popcorn and will be delivered the week before spring break. It's cash only and all the money orders are due by Friday, March 17th. For more information or to place an order, please see Ms. Van Dyke in room 350, Ms. Esper in 295, Ms. Kinzel in room A111, or Ms. Tonelli in the CTE office. Seniors, your senior trip to Cedar Point is on May 31st. If you plan on attending, you must fill out the form on your Schoology page. You can put a non-refundable deposit of $20 to hold your spot. The total cost is $125 and must be paid by April 14th. If you have any questions, please see Mr. Boyko in room A108. March is Women's History Month. This month, we will introduce you to women who have made a difference. Take a look. Amelia Earhart was the definition of a rule breaker, an American aviator who became the first woman to fly solo across the Atlantic and the first person ever to fly solo from Hawaii to the U.S. Amelia was a pioneering aviator and true female trailblazer. Earhart refused to be boxed in by her gender from a young age. Born in Kansas in 1897, Amelia played basketball growing up, took auto repair courses, and briefly attended college. In 1920, Earhart began flying lessons and quickly became determined to receive her pilot's license, passing her flight test in December 1921. Earhart set multiple aviation records, but it was her attempt at being the first person to circumnavigate the globe which led her to her disappearance and presumed death. In July 1937, Earhart disappeared somewhere over the Pacific and was declared dead in absentia in 1939. Her plane wreckage has never been found, and to this day, her disappearance remains one of the greatest unsolved mysteries of the 20th century. The Erie High School yearbook is on sale. Log into your Schoology page for a link to purchase the book. For more information, please see Mr. Gibson in room 297. Those are your morning announcements from all of us here at Royal TV. Have a royal day.